Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Dr. Barkis Ophthalmology Tutorials. Today we will again discuss two more short topics, that is astrid hylosis and synchisis scintillans. These two topics are most commonly asked for your 3-mark questions, and even the differences between these two can be asked. So in this video I will be discussing in short about these two topics of astrid hylosis and synchisis scintillans, as well as the differences between these two conditions. So without much delay, let's begin our video. The first topic is the astroid hylosis. The word astroid means something which resembles star. Okay, so how you can define this astroid hylosis? As you all know, this is one of the type of vitreous degeneration. So it is a vitreous degeneration in which calcium soaps or the calcium lipids aggregate in the vitreous. Okay, which will give an appearance of stars in the vitreous. Hence the name astroid hylosis. Okay, coming to the prevalence, it is very rare disease which is seen. Usually seen in the elderly age group with a slight male preponderance, and it is most commonly unilateral in almost 75% to 90% of the cases. So the most common association is age. As you age, you may see this astroid hylosis. Apart from that, you can also see in the diabetic retinopathy patients as well as patients with hypercholesterolemia. Usually it is asymptomatic, doesn't cause any affection to the vision. So how you see when you do the fundus examination? These are seen as whitish yellow, small or oval in shape. Okay, these opacities are attached to the collagen fibrils in the vitreous. Okay, please note there is no vitreous liquefaction here. Still the collagen fibrils are there in the vitreous, and these opacities are attached to the collagen fibrils, hence they move with the movement of the eyeball. Again moves to its original position. Okay, so that's how you can appreciate the astroid hylosis on fundus examination. So the close differentials for this astroid hylosis are amyloidosis and cholesterol bulby, also called as synchisis scintillans. There is no need of any treatment for this disease. Vitrectomy is needed only if visualization of the retina is hampered because of this astroid hylosis and the retinal disease needs treatment. Then you should go ahead with the vitrectomy and treat the retinal disease. So this is in short about astroid hylosis. Let me summarize what you should write for the 3-mark question. Just define it as vitreous degeneration in which there is calcium soap deposition. Very rare disease, usually seen in the elderly population with slight preponderance in the males and unilateral in most of the cases. And it is associated with old age, diabetic retinopathy and even the hypercholesterolemia patient. Usually asymptomatic. Have you seen the fundus examination? Whitish yellow, small oval opacities which are attached to the collagen fibrils of the vitreous, and they move with the movement of the vitreous and then they return to their original position. The close differentials are amyloidosis as well as the cholesterol bulby. Usually there is no need of any treatment. Vitrectomy is needed only if there is underlying retinal pathology which needs treatment. Okay. So moving on to the next topic, that is synchisis scintillans, also called as cholesterolosis bulby. Okay. So again, this is also a degenerative condition of the vitreous, where there is cholesterol crystals which are deposited in the vitreous. Okay, and it is usually seen in little earlier age group compared to astroid hylosis, that is in third decade, but this is also quite rare disease, bilateral in the presentation, and there is no gender or racial predilection for this synchisis scintillans. But remember, unlike the astroid hylosis, this synchisis scintillans is usually associated with other eye diseases like diabetic retinopathy, Coats disease, vitreous hemorrhage, chronic uveitis patients, mature cataract patients, retinal detachment, and even when there is trauma to the eye. So there will be some previous ocular trauma or ocular insult before this synchisis scintillans gets established. Okay, but even this disease is also asymptomatic, but the patient may experience symptoms due to the underlying eye disease which I mentioned just now. Okay, so the signs here, these cholesterol crystals are seen as small, highly refractive, these are either flat or angular in the appearance, seen in the liquefied vitreous. In the astroid hylosis there was no liquefied vitreous, but here because of the underlying ocular disease, the liquefied vitreous here, since the vitreous is liquefied, there is no collagen in the vitreous, all these crystals will sink down in the vitreous. Okay, so whenever the eye is in the immobilized position, all these crystals will go to the gravity dependent position, and once we move the eyes, it will again move like a shower of the golden crystals, that is called as golden shower, which is typical of this synchisis scintillans. Usually this is seen in the posterior segment, that is vitreous, but it can also be seen in the anterior chamber as well. Okay, so whenever it is seen in the anterior chamber, the crystals will settle down in the anterior chamber, giving the appearance of pseudo hypopia. Okay, so this is one of the DDs for your pseudo hypopia. Usually there is no need of any investigation, but whenever you see synchisis scintillans, please do look at the underlying disease which I told just now and try to treat that disease. That is more than enough, because it is a non-progressive disease and it is asymptomatic. So let me quickly summarize the synchisis scintillans, also called as cholestrolosis bulbi. It is a degenerative condition where there is cholesterol crystal in the liquefied vitreous, usually seen in the third decade, but it is also very rare disease, usually bilateral in presentation. The synchisis scintillans is rarely seen in the normal eyes, usually associated with either diabetic retinopathy, vitreous hemorrhage, Coats disease, chronic uveitis or mature cataract, retinal detachment or previous trauma to the eye. So the disease synchisis scintillans as such is asymptomatic, but patient may experience symptoms due to the underlying diseases. So when you examine the fundus, you will see small, highly refractile, flat or angular crystals which are in the liquefied vitreous. Okay. So they will settle down in the vitreous depending upon the gravity, and when we move the eyes, it will move like a golden shower. Okay. It can be seen in the posterior segment as well as the anterior chamber, giving the pseudo hypopian appearance. Whenever you see the synchisis scintillans, try to find out the underlying disease and treat that underlying disease. That is more than enough, since this is asymptomatic as well as it is non-progressive. So now we will see the differences between the astrocytic hyalosis and the synchisis scintillans, which itself can be asked for your 3-mark question. Coming to the age of onset, astrocytic hyalosis is usually seen in the elderly age group, okay? Whereas the synchisis scintillans is seen in third decade of age, okay? Coming to the laterality, astrocytic hyalosis is unilateral in almost 75% to 90% of the cases, whereas synchisis scintillans is usually bilateral in presentation. The incidence, the astrocytic hyalosis is rare disease, whereas synchisis is still rarer. Okay. Composition, the astrocytic hyalosis are made up of calcium soap or the calcium lipids, whereas synchisis are made up of cholesterol. The association, astrocytic hyalosis is usually associated with increasing age or diabetic retinopathy or hypercholesterolemia, whereas there are so many diseases which I just mentioned for the synchisis scintillans, like vitreous hemorrhage, RD, Coats disease, hypermature cataract, all those. So these appear as spherical whitish crystals in the vitreous, whereas the synchisis scintillans appearance as highly refractile, multicolored, angular are the flat crystals in the liquefied vitreous. So coming to the mobility, astrocytic hyalosis move with the movement of the eyeball and comes back to its original position, whereas in synchisis scintillans, the crystals will settle down in the liquefied vitreous. So how is the status of the vitreous in the astrocytic hyalosis? It is usually intact, means if there is no liquefaction here, no liquefaction. Whereas there is liquefied vitreous in the synchisis scintillans. The vision is usually not affected here. Even in the synchisis scintillans, because of this it is not affected, but because of the underlying disease, the vision can be affected. Treatment usually not required here in the astrocytic hyalosis, whereas in synchisis scintillans, try to treat the underlying disease. So these are the 10 differences between astrocytic hyalosis and synchisis scintillans. So just remember the headings for the differences at least: age of onset, laterality, incidence, composition of the crystals, association, appearance, mobility of these crystals, vitreous status, how is the vision, and what is the treatment. So hope this short video on astrocytic hyalosis and synchisis scintillans is useful to all of you. If you like my videos, please do subscribe to my channel. Press the bell icon for further notifications. Please do leave your valuable comments. Thank you so much.